I'm the chairman of the social media committee for Indian Association for Medical Informatics. I also run a healthcare social media agency since 2010. And that's why we're talking on social media for doctors. So social media is what burst upon us in the late 90s, at the turn of the century, when we started off with blogging and MySpace, Orkut, then Facebook came in 2005. So that is when social media picked up. Earlier than that, it was a simple one-way publication of content on the web. There was web 1.0. Then we came to blogs and social media, web 2.0. It's got a wide reach. We all know that. I had a talk in the morning on social media marketing for hospitals. We discussed over there that the reach is really wide of social media today. All of you on Facebook, all of your families on Facebook, it's wide. Exploding, the numbers keep increasing. Number of people using social media keep increasing. Instantaneous, there are lots of benefits. Instant communication, personalized to each person. It's everywhere. It's ubiquitous. You cannot stay away from social media. Better use it well. So there are various uses of social media in healthcare. Connecting two doctors. Two doctors can talk to each other. Connecting three doctors. You have apps which connects doctors together, a full community and groups of doctors. They can discuss so many things. Doctor and patient, that's another kind of social media. Doctor patient. When doctor can refer a patient to another doctor through social media. So you have two doctors talking together to one patient. That's doctor patient social media. Then you have doctor patient. When you talk to a patient and the patient gets in his or her mother or a caretaker, so that you explain to the patient and the caretaker at the same time. Social media lets you do that. Patient. Then you have two patients are discussing their own disease and symptoms amongst themselves. That's the important part of social media. It's patients using social media. You got to be mindful of that. Then you have patient communities online. Patients come together, form support groups of themselves in Alzheimer's, dementia. Genetic patients also get together and form groups. These are all various use cases of social media. Can be used for education, collaboration, exchanging notes, referrals, a lot of things. So almost all countries in the world have come up with some sort of a code for physicians. It started off with the USA in 2010 or 11, when the American Association of Physicians came up with a policy to be followed by doctors in the US. Very soon after US, followed by UK, UK came up with their own policy, Canada came up, Australia came up, India came up. IMM published a social media policy last year. So even we have joined the bandwagon, so we do have a policy in place on how social media should be used. One thing to note is most of these policies across the world have around 10 points, 10 pointers for doctors, that's all. And they appear across all the countries. It's the same 10 points plus or minus one or two, which should guide doctors and use social media. I've tried to put them all together, the 10 points. First thing is, do not fear social media. It's here, it's a wonderful tool. Use it. To use it, please, when you create your accounts, create a detailed professional account of yours, what you studied, where you practice, your qualifications, everything, because you have to build trust. Just anonymous accounts are not for you. No doctor in your name is not an account for you. You've got to have a professional social media account. Don't fear it, use it well. Strive for accuracy. Yes, language and tone you use on the social media is very important. Especially important is to use the correct grammar. One word change here and there can blow apart the matter. And people you know are anyways looking for excuses to find faults with you. Mind your language on social media. Use correct grammar. If you're not comfortable in English, don't talk in English. Use your own language. But be sure that what you write is what you think and what you're speaking is the same thing. Do not leave a chance for misunderstanding. Especially important in social media because there's no actions, gesticulations you're giving. It's simple, somebody reading a text. So grammar and tone of that communication becomes very important. Don't forward fake news. There's a lot of fake news around. WhatsApp pe roz aata hai mere ko pata nahi kya kya. Take this dawai aur sab kuch theek ho jayega. Sab kuch. You are a doctor, please don't forward this news around. Be careful because what you say creates a lot of impact, especially if it's healthcare. Even besides healthcare, do not forward fake news. No political fake news, no arson news, riot news. Mat karo na. You are a doctor, you have to maintain a dignity out there. Don't. If you can't confirm it, do not spread it out. Participate in professional discussions. If there are a few people, a few doctors talking on something which you know about, please go ahead and participate. Social media is a social activity. You have to get together. If you get a chance to showcase your knowledge, do it. You are helping yourself and everybody else around you. Don't friend your patients. Patients might send you a friend request. Please don't friend them. Like I was talking in the morning, also create two separate accounts. Create a personal account which you only share with your family and friends. And then, if I talk about Facebook, have a professional page. Facebook lets you create a profile, page, and groups. Opt for a page for your practice, for your professional professional presence, and personal keep it to yourself and to your family. Do not accept friend requests from patients. Ask them to go to your page, like the page, and then they can contact you through the page. Keep your practice on the page. Never identify a patient. You'll obviously try not to put the names or age. You'll try to change something. But there are lots of ways patients can be identified. So be very careful that you never identify a patient on social media. Sometimes the family of the patients might not support you, in the sense that if you write something about some anonymous case and the family comes to the post and says, thank you for saving a life, there goes privacy. So it's not always in your hands, but as for what is in your hands is never identify patients online. That's a simple policy, make it a policy. Never give medical advice on social media, never. All of us get lots of requests from random Facebook people, ke, sir, ye ho raha hai, mereko, please advise me medicine. Have a policy for yourself, put it on your door, on front of your computer. Never give medical advice on social media, never. Ask them to call you. If you really have to help them, ask them to give you a call. Don't go typing out prescriptions on WhatsApp or whatever. Ask them to call you. Take it offline. Make a policy for yourself. There are just 7-8 points which you have to follow. Don't wait ke jab mauka aayega to I'll behave accordingly. No, have 7-8 points. This is what I am going to do on social media. This is what I am not going to do on social media. Keep it there, put it next to your computer, stick to it. Start with creating a policy for yourself, stick to it. Never type angry. Log pareshan karte hain, gussa aata hai, type karke bhej diya, 2 min baad lagta hai ki yaar theek nahi kiya maine, lekin ho jata hai. Never type angry, gussa aaya, sleep on it. Subah dekhna kya kar raha hai. Raat ko usi waqt, you don't have to type and get back and get your point across, ki maine bhi wapas maar diya. Nahin. Never get angry, keep it, sleep it, keep your perspective. Online hai, keep your perspective, maintain dignity. Give benefit of doubt. Like I said, text reading mein tone sometimes gets misunderstood. So give a benefit of doubt. Repeat offenders hote hue baat lage, but pehli baar mein kisi baat ka bura manna jaruri nahi hai ki he meant what you think he meant. Don't throw stones. Logon par patthar mat pheko. आपको भी लोग पत्थर फेंकेंगे. बी रिस्पेक्टफुल, मेंटेन डिग्निटी, शो प्रोफेशनल डिग्निटी, एस्पेशली विद योर पीयर्स. अ लॉट ऑफ केसेस व्हेन डॉक्टर पीयर्स आर फाइटिंग ऑन सोशल मीडिया, दैट्स अ बिग नो नो. डोंट, स्टे अवे फ्रॉम दिस. डोंट थ्रो स्टोन्स एट अदर्स, दे विल थ्रो स्टोन्स बैक एट यू. हेटर्स विल हेट. आप कितना भी ध्यान रखोगे, लोग आएंगे, गालियां देंगे. इग्नोर रिपीट ऑफेंडर्स एंड ट्रोल्स. जो बार बार कर, पहली बार आपको लगता है चलो ठीक है, he must have a point of view. Second time, third time, then you know he's a troll. वो आपको सिर्फ तंग करने आया है. Block him. You have the option, right? Block him, ना? Just block him. Take control of your privacy. Go to your accounts. Every account, every social media account, Facebook, LinkedIn, Twitter, everything has privacy settings where you can block people, where you can put a setting that my posts should only be seen by friends or by family. It should not be seen publicly. By default, all social media posts are public. Everybody can see it. Go to your privacy settings, change it. Can be seen only by friends. That's it. Take control of your privacy settings. You will save yourself a lot of headache. LinkedIn is a professional networking platform. I use it a lot. LinkedIn is more of a business-to-business network kind of a thing. So if you're looking for patients, LinkedIn might not be a very good...
I don't think I need a patient. I need my friends on LinkedIn have some professional touch. What you are suggesting?
Right. Yeah, I like LinkedIn in the sense that I get to connect with lots of different professionals. But if you're looking for a doctor network, then go to DocPlexus. It's a much better. They have more better content. Their members there are more more active. People help each other. LinkedIn is more business, corporate types. But yes, you should go beyond Facebook. Go to DocPlexus is a good thing. There's another network called Daily Rounds. They publish a lot of CME content. So choose your network and participate actively in this. That's what I say. Yeah.